tonight.
Hey, welcome back to Morning Joe. So get out your wallet, put your sports knowledge to the test. Gambling on the big games can now be a reality in every state across the country.
All right, the Supreme Court ruled that individual states should be allowed to sponsor sports betting if they want. This reverses a 1992 decision that banned such betting in 46 states. Now it will be up to individual states to decide if they want any sort of sports gambling. And it could be different state by state, based on laws and politics, of course, and whether or not the gaming would be done online or at casinos or both. We spoke with Kate Lowenar Fisher, a Nevada gaming attorney, who felt the ruling can help reduce the fallout from illegal gambling.
We need to confront the reality that betting on sports has always been a favorite pastime in the United States. And now we can bring it out into the light. You know, we can get the unscrupulous operators out of it. People's money can be safe. We can have know your customer protections, problem gambling protections, protections against minors betting, and all those kinds of things that come with a regulated market.
Well, while legalizing sports betting could help eliminate illegal gambling and be a boom for the economy, there are downsides to any risky financial activity. So we asked credit expert Max Scholes about that.
There are certainly issues of addiction that are a concern. And from the banking perspective, when you're giving people money to literally gamble, there's a whole lot of risk inherent there for the banks. So there's no question that there are a lot of risk involved, whether you're talking about on a personal level, gambling, having the possibility of gambling too much or feeding addictions, or on the financial side where there's a lot of financial risk of loss.
Another consideration is how sports betting would affect the sports leagues themselves. Integrity fees is when some of the leagues want to get a part of the profits from businesses letting people bet on their sports. And if the leagues manage to take too much, the cost could put some gaming outlets out of business, which would help illegal bookies.
Mm-hmm. All right, the NFL has actually came out and released a statement against this decision. They were the big league we were talking about off the top. It read in part, "We intend to call on Congress again, this time to enact a core regulatory framework for legalized sports betting. We also will work closely with our clubs to ensure that any state efforts that move forward in the meantime protect our fans and the integrity of the game." So, Layla,
break this down in layman's terms.
Get your bets in. Well, you can't necessarily bet in, let's say, New England. If you're a Patriots fan, you can't walk into a casino there and put a bet on that. You can go into Vegas and these legalized sports books and do that. So this just allows now if you have a team that didn't have a state gambling allowance before, now you can walk into really any establishment that gets, you know, approved by the state if they say, okay, go in there and put a bet down. So it's not going to financially hurt the NFL, but what they're saying right there is, well, this could potentially affect the integrity of the game because who's to say a player isn't going to put $1 million to say, hey, we're going to lose this game and I'm not going to catch these passes because of that. So that's a really, really slim possibility of happening. But of course, the NFL wants to also protect that because they don't get a cut of that money.
Mm-hmm. And they want all the money.
Exactly. They just want all the money. And that's why the NFL is really against this. All right.